dissection of the heart, anatomy, cardiovascular system. In this video, we'll see something different. We'll analyze a real heart, not human, but swine. A swine heart is used due to its similarity to the human heart. It's only a little bigger. First of all, we can already macroscopically observe that we're seeing the interior portion and more specifically, the ventricular portion, because we can see the atrioventricular sulcus that divides it from the atrial portion. We can already notice the difference between the right part and the left part of the heart. The right part, in fact, is easier to compress. The left, instead, is harder. This is due to the different muscular thickness of the two walls. Well, this particular heart presents a large cut that was inflicted at the end of butchering in order to do sanitary controls on the animal. Well, another thing to be observed about the external configuration is undoubtedly the sulci. They are furrows in which the branches of the coronaries run. We have the atrioventricular sulcus that divides the atria from the ventricles, both in front and behind. The one above is the atrial portion, the lower one instead, the ventricular. Then we have the posterior interventricular sulcus and the anterior interventricular sulcus, much more evident, in which a large branch of the anterior interventricular runs. Another visible branch of the coronary circulation is represented by the arteries of the acute margin on the left side of the heart. Observing the base of the heart, vascular structures that enter and exit it can be seen. This is the pulmonary trunk, and we know that by the fact that by inserting a probe in it, we can touch the right ventricle. Immediately behind the pulmonary trunk is obviously the aorta, and we know it is the aorta because by inserting a probe in it and pushing, we wind up along the wall of the left ventricle. We can then see a series of venous structures at the base, like the superior vena cava, and therefore we are in the right atria, or the pulmonary veins, and here you can see 1 and 2. Well, now we can proceed to the opening of the atrial and ventricular structures, and let's begin with the right atria. Well, let's start cutting along the vena cava and follow the usual order that is used during autopsy. We'll therefore follow the same path that blood does. After the right atria, we'll go to the right ventricle. Afterwards, we'll move to the left. What we see here is the inside of the right atria along the medial wall. Even though it is not easily seen, you can feel the fossa ovalis, residue of the foramen that connected the two atria during intrauterine life. Below, you can note, even if it is collapsed, the tricuspid valve orifice. The last thing to notice about the atria is the fact that by inserting a guide along the lateral wall, we find the auricle that we know is hollow. Well, at this point, we can continue cutting the edge of the heart to observe what is inside the ventricle. Here, we see the passage between the atrium and the right ventricle. What we see here is a cusp of the tricuspid valve, and this is a piece of its fibrous ring. Well, notice the resistance when pulled. Furthermore, the valve has the chorda tendinae that, as we know, are attached to the papillary muscles that are these bumps on the wall. The chorda tendinae have an impressive resistance to being pulled, so much so that, even trying to pull them with great force, they're not damaged. Therefore, all summed up, what we now saw was the receptive part of the right ventricle. Well, we didn't observe the infundibular part, that instead is smooth. Well, let's try to insert a guide then. As you can see, the guide exists at the pulmonary trunk, and this demonstrates how much smaller the ejection cone is when compared to the receptive part of the ventricle. Well, now we are sectioning the pulmonary trunk wall. Observe the white color of the media. Here we completed the opening of the pulmonary trunk. We are at the base, and what you see here are two of the three semilunar valves that close the pulmonary trunk during diastole. Observe here how thin these structures are, but at the same time they are extremely resistant to being pulled. At this point, we are opening the left portion of the heart, so let's begin with the left atrium, cutting transversely so as to open the pulmonary vein sinus. After opening it, we can see how down deep this one also presents a collapsed atrioventricular valve, in this case, the mitral. Furthermore, the structure that can be seen on the medial wall of this atrium is the semilunar plica, that is also a residue of the foramen ovalis. Well, we also opened a second plane to see the passage from the atrium to the ventricle. What we notice is first of all the atrioventricular valve with its robust cusps. Then we have the cord tannini, here also very resistant, but the most interesting thing is the thickness of the wall, that is almost 7 times thicker than the right ventricles. Furthermore, even if we are observing the receptive portion, we can note how it is less wrinkled than the right ventricles. At this point, let's try and insert a probe to observe the communication with the aorta. Here we are visualizing the way to the external left ventricle, the axis the blood flows to the aorta. Now, let's open the aorta to observe its semilunar valve. As you can see, the semilunar cuffs are very, very similar to those semilunar cuffs of the pulmonary trunk. Nonetheless, here the aortic sinus, Vasalva sinus, can be seen better, that is, the swelling that is immediately posterior to each of the cusps. Furthermore, we can see the orifices of origin of the coronary arteries. This is the entrance of the right coronary. Almost symmetrically, instead, we have the entrance for the left coronary. The last thing that we'll observe in this autopsy is the different thickness between the ventricle walls, making a transverse cut of the ventricles. Well, so, you can see well how the right ventricle has a larger cavity but a rather thin wall. And you can see how the thickness of the wall of the left ventricle is extremely large compared to the right one. Thank you for watching. This video was created by School of Biomedical Sciences, Agorà. We hope you enjoyed it. If you're curious or have any doubt or question, please feel free to leave a comment below. If you want to find out more about us or want to support our project, click on the following link to visit our website.